set out on a journey to find the remaining natural forests in Sweden to do a study in them. So we basically went on a almost 2 months long road trip together.
We started in the north of Sweden, like around the Arctic Circle, and then we just went through all these small villages all the way down to the south of Sweden.
Most of Sweden is covered in managed forest, so we have like vast stretches of a forest that is very even aged, has the same tree species, is very managed and gets cut in like regular intervals. That's how forests are usually managed in Sweden. But in some of these forests, there's some small patches that have never been touched, never been cut. And these are quite difficult to find. They have been mapped on data that exists, and we set out to find them and to study them. So we sat in the car, we tried to find the GPS coordinates, and we never knew if we would actually find it or not.
Yeah, we kind of started every day with just looking at the map and the coordinates, and then we just sat in the car and we just started on a big road, and then you go to a smaller road, an even smaller road, and then a gravel road, and then finally it's like, is it even a road? You don't know. And then you just try to find somewhere to park the car, and then you just go in there, and yeah, what you find is quite amazing.
Through the bushes, and you fight your way through some undergrowth, and then you're suddenly in this forest that is so, you can just see it is old, and you have the trees are big, and there's so much diversity. There's,
you have like these layers of, yeah, like it's not one dimension of vegetation. It's exactly. Like there's mosses growing on top of something else, and then some species growing on top of something else. It's like if you go to a rainforest, it's the same thing. It's like so many more species that grows on top of each other and are dependent on each other. You have hanging lichens, and you have small really rare lichens or mosses, and
it's just full of life, like it's
and
not
death.
Just about and death,
and death, true. Which is good. A lot of dead trees, like, yeah, big trunks just lying there.
It's something very special, at least for me. I've never really been into like an old forest before. And it feels very special. You feel really connected to nature.
I get this mixed feeling, actually. I get this really nice, I just get filled with this super beautiful, amazing forest, which give me a calm feeling. Like I want to explore. I want to go in there and just search for species and things. But then I get this also sad feeling of like all those forests that we passed that were like that. And many times we passed like these huge clear cuts before or something, and you just imagine all those species that were lost.
Yeah, and you think about how all the forest could look like. But it's also very lucky that you can do this in Sweden, that you still have these kinds of forests, and that you, because in a lot of countries that's actually not possible. So that's also something really beautiful.
Yeah, you feel that it's a unique place. I mean, you feel that you have this unique opportunity to be there. Every person who comes to one of those forests get amazed. It's not an everyday forest. It's a special place.
So they've been left alone completely, so everything is how it's evolving in nature by itself. So you still have all the lakes, you have the wet lands, you have dead wood lying around where, as Ulrika said, you have the lichen and the fungi and thriving in it. And so you have the circle of how an ecosystem functions in itself that is disrupted.
It's a full ecosystem instead of like a smaller version. In the managed forest, we have an ecosystem, but it's like a smaller version of what it used to be. We don't have all the species.
The aim of our study was to measure carbon storage in these forests, since we don't really know how much carbon they store. And it's important to know, since we have to think about how are we going to go into the future with climate change, and how are we gonna think about to capture carbon. And so it's important to know if these forests still store carbon and how much they store, and also if they are still taking up carbon, because that's something that's actually not completely clear. We don't know if these old forests that are like peak ecosystems, if they still take up more carbon. And so that was is also one of the future aims, is to see how they change over time.
We had these plots where we measured all the trees. We measured all living and dead trees, and we also measured the carbon in the soil. So that was what we were doing all days. We were measuring trees
and walking through the forest.
I love to be out in field. It's just so much fun. You're in this team and you just get to know each other. You share a lot of things during the day. You work together. Yeah, you have all your tasks. You do that, I do that. And then you get this machine going that you just like, you go to a new forest, you know what to do. And then after a while, you just like, you know exactly what to do. And you get to know each other in a very nice way.
I think the most fun thing is that you never know what's going to happen. You don't know how the village is going to be that you're staying in. You don't know how the forest is going to be. And the forests are very different. Like, some of them are very dry and you have to climb over stones. And you have maybe like a whole field of big boulders that you have to get through to the other side to get to your plot. Or it's super wet and you didn't bring any boots for it, so you have to figure out a way to not just get wet all over. So that's a lot of fun. And then figuring out how to navigate the forest, jumping over streams, just very, like an adventure, really. Yeah, like an expedition into the unknown.